Melbourne's southeast is firming as a major battleground as Victorians prepare to go to the polls twice within 11 months. Today, more than $100 million of government funding kicked into gear as both the Liberal and Labor parties attempt to secure seats.
It's rare to see a Labor and Liberal politician together in hard hats. But nothing unites both sides of politics quite like transport infrastructure.
There's a number of roundabouts here on major local roads that really do cause some congestion during peak times.
State Minister Jacinta Allan joined her federal counterpart Paul Fletcher to signal the start of work on a $113 million upgrade to the Western Port Highway.
We do work with state governments here in Victoria and all around the country in a cooperative fashion.
But there's more at play. Federal Labor holds the seat of Holt, which takes in the growth suburbs of Cranbourne and Clyde. Anthony Byrne is the member by a near 9% margin. But in state politics, Labor holds the nearby seats of Cranbourne, Carrum, Frankston, Narre Warren North and South. The Liberals are trying to win some of those seats back and sandbagging to save Brad Batten in the redistributed seat of Berwick after the old seat, Gembrook, was held with a margin of less than 1%.
So are these areas important because of politics? No, they're important because of people, and they're sick of being neglected by the Victorian Labor Party.
The Liberals so concerned, Matthew Guy spent 2 days this week campaigning in the seat.
Political analysts also believe that the South East Corridor is an important strategic target for both major parties, not only because of the infrastructure needs, but also the need for more affordable housing.
We've got heaps of growth areas, younger populations going in, new housing estates, and there'll be demands.
Oh, well, look, it's a bit early in the year, Simon, to be an election commentator.
But never too early for a picture opportunity. Simon Love for 10 News First.